In February this year, Russia attacked Ukraine and in doing so sent shockwaves through global food chains. However, the war has also had a more indirect but crucial effect on agriculture in the EU. Prices for fertilizers, a key input for farmers, are going through the roof as supplies shrink. This has become a major challenge to farmers. For certain types of fertilizer, prices in the EU went up by almost 150% over the last year. What are the reasons behind this fertilizer crisis that Europe is facing? Let's take a closer look. Fertilizers are crucial for food production. They supply the soil with the extra nutrients necessary to reliably produce the quantities that are needed to feed a growing population. When you hear the word fertilizer, you might think of manure. But in reality, most farms rely heavily on mineral or chemical fertilizers, also known as synthetic fertilizers. And this is where the current crisis comes in. Synthetic fertilizer supply in Europe has been hit with a kind of double whammy. Not only have there been disruptions to imports into the EU, but domestic production has also been affected by the gas price spike. Let's talk about imports first. 60% of EU fertilizer imports come from two countries, Russia and Belarus, who mine large amounts of mineral fertilizer and have traditionally been major suppliers to the EU. These supplies are now largely missing from the EU market. In the case of Belarus, back in March this year, the EU banned all imports of potash, one of the big three fertilizer types. This was part of the sanctions imposed following the forced landing of a Ryanair flight in Minsk in summer 2021. Turning to Russia, the situation is a little more complicated. Contrary to Kremlin propaganda, fertilizers are, in principle, not part of the sanctions that the EU has taken against Moscow in response to the invasion of Ukraine. In fact, EU representatives have repeatedly stressed that sanctions do not include goods that are important for food production. However, fertilizer trade was impacted by the deteriorating relationship between the EU and Moscow, as well as Russia's ban from the global banking system. Additionally, the EU has banned all imports of Belarus-style potash from Russia in efforts to ensure that Belarus cannot sell their mineral fertilizers through Russia. In short, imports of mineral fertilizers from two of the EU's main suppliers have been disrupted. On top of this, domestic producers of chemical fertilizers have been hard hit by the current energy crisis and record gas prices. Fossil gas is an indispensable ingredient to chemical fertilizer production. With gas sparse and expensive, fertilizer producers had to up prices or even produce less, the industry warns. As European gas costs are 8 to 10 times higher than, say, in the US, production in Europe is just not competitive anymore. The industry association Fertilizers Europe estimates that around 70% of European production capacity for ammonia, an important fertilizer, has been curtailed. In the face of these massive challenges, many have called on the European Commission to take EU-level action. And indeed, EU Commissioner Janusz Wojciechowski recently announced that the EU executive will table a new communication on fertilizers. However, in EU speak, a communication is a non-binding paper that will not include any actual policy action. Meanwhile, others say farms should work to reduce their reliance on synthetic fertilizers altogether by using organic methods instead. Yet, this would likely reduce yields. Either way, farmers are in a tough spot, and tackling the fertilizer conundrum will be one of the main challenges for EU agricultural policy in the upcoming months. Affordable food supply and the stability of the agricultural sector depend on it.